Good day everyone. In today's tutorial, I want to show you how to do contour mapping using Sofa Golden software. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. The data I want to use is a record which has this field. I have location, I have X which is longitude and latitude. Then I have record. This one can be elevation or your lab results. So I have XYZ data in Excel. So it has been saved in Excel sheet. Now to use this to produce contour map in Sofa software. So launch the Sofa software. When you launch it, this is how the interface looks like. Now the first thing to do is to bring in the data. But before you can do that, you have to grid it. So come under home, you see grid data. So we have to grid that Excel data into formats that this software will accept and use. So click on grid data, then here click on browse to navigate to where you have that data. So I have it on desktop in this exercise folder. So this is it, record in Excel format. Click on it and click open. So now when you click open here, X, make sure it is X, that is longitude, and Y, make it Y. Then Z is our record or elevation. Now after you have done this, we have different method of grading. So we have in a lot of them, you can just browse through or try all of them and see the difference. So but today we are going with the first one, which is gridging. So choose that one, then if you click next, you can see the variogram of our data. You can see it, you can read more about this, and if you click next, you can see information about the data we enter, and of course somehow like preview of how the data will look like. You can see the minimum X, maximum X, and all the field, the minimum and the maximum. So then if you click next, you can see the cross validation, and this line is the reference line, and you can see this line the best fit. So then here you can see information about your data. Then if you click next, you can see the summary or output grid geometry here. So then click on finish, so it will grid the data. Click on OK and close this. Click no. Actually, I set this software so that when I bring in data, it automatically generates contour map for me. But however, if let me remove this, let me delete. Now after we have gridded it, it has saved it in that very folder where we did the gridding. So to produce contour map, under home here, you will see different maps here, icon to this type of maps. So click on contour. When you click on contour, it will ask for the data you want to use to produce the contour. So navigate to record or the data you have gridded, and this is it in our case. Click on open. So when you click on open, it will automatically generate your contour map for you, just like this. If you wish to adjust it, click on it and adjust it. If you wish to, like for example, let's expand it like this. Let's expand it to cover the whole interface of the screen. So now, after you have done that, you can see here, make sure you highlight it. Once you highlight here, the contour map will be highlighted. Then come to properties. Under general, here you can see this is the location of our record, and here is information. You can look for check information about the data, and this is where the grid is kept. And if you click here, you can equally save it. Then this is our fourth line. You can change the line style and you can change the color. However, the most important one is this level. come to level. Here in level, you can see informations here, and here, if you want color scale, you can check it. But before then, you can see major contour, so you can increase or decrease it. And here you can see information, you can see the minimum contour and maximum contour. So if I reduce this, you can see the interval or contour is changing, you can see. But I think let's leave it at 5. Then if you want the color scale, click on it, you can see the color scale here, you can see it here. So let's go back to the properties. Then here, fill color. This fill color, if you check it, you can see our map will be filled, and you can change the fill color. If you click on this drop down, you can see different color that you can change it to. You can see the color. If you are not satisfied with it, you can change to another color like this, or the first color we chose, just like this. So then the line properties, you can equally change it as well. You can change the color and you can change the width. That is for major contour. So if you increase it, for example, you can see as I'm increasing it, you can see the contour lines, the major contour lines is increasing. So you can also change the opacity, and you can change the color of the contour line. Then show label. If you want it to show label, you can. That is for minor contour. If I click on show label, you can see that the map is noisy, too cloudy. So let me uncheck it. I think the major contour line labeling is enough. So then if you come to font properties, you can see you can change the size here. Instead of 11, you can increase, you can decrease. And background color, if you want it to be bold, you can click it to make it bold, the labeling bold. And if you come to layer, under layer, you can reduce or increase the opacity just like this. Then if you come here, for example, this axis, we may want to adjust the axis. So for example, this left axis, click on it to select it and come to properties. So this axis, the lines, you can choose to change the lines, the ticks and the labeling. You can try to adjust it as well. Even the labeling, you may want to increase the angle just like this, or decrease it if you want it to be vertical like this or horizontal. You can make it according to your preference. So in essence, this is how to produce contour maps in Golden Surfer software. So in the next tutorial, we are going to check how to add map elements in Surfer software. So thank you for watching.